WWDC 2021 Apple Previews. What is next for iPhones, iPads, and Macs? The Worldwide Developer Conference happened this year, as it does every year. The keynote address by Craig Federighi has become a part of the Apple culture for all who love the brand. All updates are discussed in this address, and here was what was in the address this year. The announcement was on the details of the release of iOS 15. The new release focuses on 4 points: staying connected, finding focus, using intelligence, and exploring the world. The updated iOS will be released in public beta in July, while the full release will be rolled out this fall. Here are all the updates added to the Apple operating system and all you missed at the WWDC 2021. Before we get into that, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button so you will never miss any of our future videos. FaceTime. FaceTime will get spatial audio. Using a compatible audio setup, spatial audio will seem more like the other person's voice coming from their on-screen position. It will also feature voice isolation. Better voice isolation for FaceTime when you are in a loud environment is available in the upcoming update. In addition, the portrait mode from the camera app will be added to FaceTime. This addition will provide better background blurring. One of the most exciting additions is the shareable FaceTime links that can now be generated and shared. Others, including desktop and Android users, can join FaceTime calls through a browser. FaceTime will also allow shared audio-video streams to allow you to listen to music, watch videos from selected video partners, and control apps in sync with friends. They call this SharePlay. The shared videos can be pushed to Apple TV and kept in sync between devices and households. All of this through FaceTime. Focus. You will be able to shift your phone through different customized modes now, so you can separate your apps between work and personal. You can turn off the personal customization if you are at work or turn off work when you are at home. Another way to focus is to batch your notifications. You can make your phone batch up your less important notifications and deliver them at one time of your choosing instead of having them all trickle every time. Live text. The camera can now recognize text in photos and make it selectable, searchable, and copy and pastable. The camera will also recognize animal breeds, landmarks, and other things either handwritten or printed. Apple Wallet. Apple is moving further to incorporate home, office, and hotel keys into Apple Wallet. This move allows you to unlock compatible doors in those places with your phone. You will be able to check into select hotels and have your room key show up on your phone as soon as your room is ready. In addition, the company is working with TSA in some states to put an encrypted copy of your driver's license in the Apple Wallet that will be accepted at security screenings. Apple Maps. Maps is getting a detail-focused overhaul, with additional 3D elevation maps, 3D rendered landmarks, crosswalks, bike lanes, among others. Apple Maps also includes a mode that has you use the camera to scan nearby buildings to more precisely orient your phone and help you figure out the direction to take. But again, this is a cue from Google Maps. AirPods update. Conversation mode is different now. AirPods Pro will allow you to boost the volume of voices and control the volume of ambient noise of those around you when you're having a face-to-face conversation in a noisy environment. AirPods will now work with the Find My app even when they're in the case and will be able to alert you if you leave them behind. The spatial audio is coming to tvOS and M1-powered Macs. iPadOS. iPadOS will get home screen widgets. They're similar to those on iOS, with the addition of a much bigger widget option. The app library concept is making its way from iOS to iPadOS as well. A new multitasking menu will simplify the way you handle multitasking on iPadOS, moving the system away from the easily forgotten gestures currently required. The Notes app will now let you mention someone in a shared note to get their attention on a change and highlight changes when you return to a shared document. A Quick Notes app will let you create a note from anywhere by swiping it up from the bottom right corner of the screen. A translation update is available. iPadOS will get a system-wide text translate option, along with an app for translating in-person conversations in real time. Swift Playgrounds will now let you build apps on the iPad and submit them to the App Store. Security updates. The Mail app will automatically obscure your IP address and location from those invisible tracking pixels marketers love to tuck into emails. An app privacy report option is available to summarize how any given app accesses your location and photos and hopefully flag any unwarranted behavior. Siri's speech recognition will also now happen on device, keeping the audio recordings off Apple servers and allowing for Siri commands without an internet connection. iCloud accounts will be accepting recovery contacts now. If you ever got locked out of your iCloud account, friends could help you get back in if you have them as your recovery contacts. If you should pass away, a legacy contact could take over your iCloud account. You have to update the legacy contact on the new iOS. Health updates. Your iPhone can now analyze your gait, step, and timing to determine your walking steadiness to flag if your fall risk is increasing over time. A trend summary in the Health app will highlight patterns in your step counts, heart rate, and rest. In addition, new health sharing options will let you securely share health data with people you care about, like that of your parents or your kids. WatchOS. The WatchOS will now be able to track respiratory rates. There are workout modes that have been added to the activity tracking. You can now have a portrait mode photo of yourself on the clock layout. Text input includes scribble handwriting recognition, and you can now place the cursor and then draw the letters and symbols you want on top of the text. Siri expansion. Apple says that it is opening Siri up to third-party manufacturers and their devices, allowing Siri to live on things like Ecobee thermostats by the end of the year. macOS. The next release of macOS will be called macOS Monterey. The SharePlay feature mentioned for FaceTime is also coming to macOS. A universal control is coming to MacBook. You can use one mouse or keyboard setup to control multiple Macs and iPads. There will be automatic recognition of nearby devices as well. If you send AirPlay content to your Apple TV, you can send it to your Mac's display. The Shortcuts automation system is coming to macOS. It allows you to drag and drop together scripts to do the things you find yourself often doing. Safari is getting a UI overhaul to design things better. Tabs are getting smaller, and they are introducing a tab group system to keep things organized. The tab groups will automatically sync between iCloud devices. Development. The new developments are usually kept till the breakout sessions. The conference usually focuses on consumer interests, but some tech developments have happened. New APIs have been developed to look into things like SharePlay and Focus. The iOS is getting a built-in 3D object scanning system that developers can tie into their apps, allowing them to integrate 3D scanning style functionality without reinventing that wheel. Developers will now build multiple App Store product pages for the same app with different icons, screenshots, to see which one resonates best. The test flight service for privately distributing pre-release Macs on Apple's phones, tablets, and watch operating systems is coming to macOS. The Worldwide Developers Conference is an exciting time for Apple fans all over the world. The streams and Twitter commentary says it all. We would like to know if you enjoy the event and which of these new updates you look forward to.